Hey guys, in this new video, we're gonna get to see how exactly do we approach a weak acid-based titration. Now, we already know this. We said in the past, we reacted weak acids and weak bases with water and used an ice chart. And remember, when we're dealing with acids and bases in our ice charts, the units in the ice chart had to be in molarities. So we needed moles over liters. And remember, ice stood for initial change equilibrium. Now we're going to react these weak acids and weak bases, not with water, but with strong acids and bases. And we're going to say when you react a weak species with a strong species, so a weak acid with a strong base, or a weak base with a strong acid, we no longer are going to use an ice chart. Instead, we're going to use a new chart. We're going to use an ICF chart. And here, we're going to say ICF stands for initial change final. And it becomes imperative that you guys remember how to identify compounds as either being an acid or base, weak or strong. If you guys can't remember how to do that, then learning to use an ICF chart becomes that much more difficult. Here we're going to say an ice chart is in molarity, but an ICF chart is in moles. So just remember this. If we have a weak acid or a weak base by itself, not being titrated with any other type of compound, it reacts with water in an ice chart. If we have a weak acid or base now being mixed in with a strong acid or base, then we now have to go and do an ICF chart. So remember that difference.